Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays. I want to say a quick thank you for making our days so amazing. And well, here's to many more years to come. I really hope that we can do the same and make your days a little bit amazing too. So this weekend, we expect many to have gotten a new VR headset under the tree, most likely a Quest 2. So I wanted to make this video with my personal favorite VR games of the year to make it easier for you to know where to spend your money on. Many of these titles are also in a great holiday sale right now until December 26th at 11:59 p.m. Pacific time, which I will link below. So even if you're playing later, now is probably the best time to buy. And if you're watching later, then these are just also my personal favorites of the past year that I highly recommend. So I'm Kaz, and this is your channel for VR. Consider subscribing for more Quest content. And now let's get started. Join me beyond reality. Okay, so this list isn't in any particular order, as all these games are just amazing. So let's start with Demio. Gather your friends and battle the dark forces that have overtaken the world of RPG dungeon crawler Demio. See it as a lightweight version of Dungeons & Dragons, except in VR, the little pawns actually come to life. Strategy and communication is key in this game, and the game mechanics are so well done that it makes for such a fun experience. They are currently under third DLC, and moving into 2022, they still have a long roadmap of new updates coming up to keeping the game fresh even if you already have it. This is currently my top favorite shoujo VR game. A Township Tale isn't far off being my top favorite either, because this is a multiplayer open world RPG with survival elements, realistic physics, and deep crafting mechanics. You can do and discover so much, like you have to decide on one of the 10 classes you want to become, you have 10 areas to explore, and you have a lot of blueprints for weapons to find and then to craft. Then the crafting is truly on another level. It's not easy to do, it has a steep learning curve, but the devs have been working for years on iterating the mechanics that it feels so polished and satisfying doing the crafting. Everything can be done together too with friends, as you can open up your server for up to 8 players. A Township Tale is truly a hidden gem that you just have to discover. After the Fall is probably the most recent release in this list, and damn, it has blasted its way into my favorites. This 4-player co-op shooter from the devs of Arizona Sunshine is like Valve's Left 4 Dead, but then in VR. It pits you against hordes of zombies across a handful of linear levels, where you have to kill the Snowbreed in a post-apocalyptic LA, and you do that to collect harvest, which in turn is used to make upgrades to your weapons or to get skins. It's a bit grindy, but oh, so addictive. A very well-rounded VR multiplayer shooter that completely caught me off guard this month, as I just cannot seem to stop thinking about it. Song in the Smoke has a good mix of the usual exciting survival mechanics and a strange kind of spiritual atmosphere that can take you by surprise. It has a prehistoric vibe, as you will encounter strange but beautiful otherworldly dinosaur beasts. You will be thrown into the deep with the complex crafting systems, as the game does not hold your hand. You always have a sense of urgency, as you'll be given just enough resources to do what you need, but sometimes just not enough to make it tense and thrilling. It's just a good survival game that I think any survival fan would enjoy. Now, this is a golden oldie for me, as this is just a charming game that takes heavy inspiration from one of my favorites, the Legend of Zelda franchise. It's a polished and well-rounded action adventure that takes you across a variety of biomes, wielding a sword, shield, and crossbow, as you fight dozens of fantasy beasts. It's an older game released a while ago, but still one of the games that impacted me most. If you haven't tried it yet, I still highly recommend it. Moss should not be missed while we're talking about the golden oldies. While the game is short, around 2 hours of playtime, I still think it is the best third-person platformer game, because the studio behind Moss was able to create an emotional connection between the player and the little mouse protagonist Quill, who you control using traditional face buttons on your controller, and then using your You brew hands, you manipulate the environment to help her on her mission to save her uncle and the world. It's hard to tell you how amazing the game is. You should just try it out if you haven't yet. You also be ready for the sequel of the game coming out somewhere next year. Resident Evil 4, what can I say about it except that it's a fantastic port of an already excellent game. Now, for the first time ever, it is completely playable in first person. At first, I was worried that the game would have too many cutscenes in VR, as it's just not an easy task to bring such an old game into VR, and that's why it has a lot of cutscenes. But the devs did a great job, and many fans have told me, who have played the game before, that the game feels like a completely new game to them now. I'm lucky because I'm playing the game for the first time in VR, and I think it is probably more scary now, as all the evil is up on your face, which just means it is also more immersive. Unplugged was also a surprise to me this year, and this game smartly uses the Quest 2's hand tracking, allowing you to play air guitar and making you feel awesome while doing it. It truly feels like a next level Guitar Hero game, and the songs list is great, which is kinda important in these games. Unfortunately, the game is held back a little by the hand tracking limitations of the Quest 2, but I find that if you find a good room with good lighting, it will be hard for any rhythm game fan to put this away. So Sniper Elite VR was also a surprise to me, as it sticks true to its name by delivering a truly satisfying sniper gameplay, including that signature in-game slow motion kill cam after you've taken an epic shot and then it makes you feel epic. The story could be a little bit better, but it didn't matter to me as much, as sometimes I just enjoy some mindless action. It's the first VR game in the franchise, and I genuinely hope that the developers will consider making more. I Expect You to Die 2 is a light-hearted single-player puzzle game that's played seated. This is a sequel to an already successful game, and a worthy one. It's done a masterful job at delivering a really fun puzzle game, and you know, I don't usually like puzzles, as they just frustrate me. It's because even though you're an important spy trying to prevent world domination by an evil corporation, you are immersed in a world that has a cheeky, James Bond-like tone and a cool retro art style. While it lacks a bit in immersive object interaction, it makes up for it in the 6 missions, as they are all rich in detail, has intriguing puzzles, and plenty of plot twists that will keep you playing. Blade & Sorcery Nomad is a wonder to me, as it's a sandbox that relies on heavy physics-based melee combat. It sounds like a simple fighting game, however the action is based on complex real-world physics, so every object has weight, realistic weight, which means you actually have to swing your weapons with force, making the combat feel realistic and hard to master. I didn't think this would be possible on a standalone VR headset, yet the developers have been able to compromise just enough to keep the game fun. Of course, it isn't as great as the PC VR version, and the game still needs some more work, but even in this current state, I mean, it has mods as well, I think it's still one of the most entertaining titles to play. It is one of those games that you can only play in VR. Now, if you like battle royales, then Population 1 was the top favorite of the year. Here you dive into a huge map where teams of 3 battle it out to be the last one standing. It's like Fortnite with some of its iconic mechanics like the climbing, gliding, and scaling up walls with your hands. While it has lost a bit of its online player count, it is still one of the most played battle royales on Quest, and the devs are still active, hosting fun events during the holidays. Until You Fall is another hidden gem, as nobody seems to talk about it, yet it is such a good game. It is a unique VR sword fighting game that combines hack and slashing with RPG combat. It's a roguelite too, so it's a highly replayable game, and combine that with it being a secret workout app, as it will give you a full body workout without making you feel like you're working it out. It is just gold, and a game that I'm still playing after so many years. I guess that says enough too, right? Last but not least, The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners. Next to Half-Life Alyx, it is still one of the games I name as one of my favorites of all time because of the amazing storytelling and the incredible zombie fighting mechanics based on realistic physics, and I still haven't seen this anywhere else yet. The game does the TV show right too, as it is able to give you the exact same feeling of urgency that you see in the TV show when you're in the dangerous outside world trying to scavenge for the scarce resources to survive another day. It is a shooter and survival horror game, so it's not for the faint-hearted, but even so, I highly recommend everyone to try it out. You may know that I am a horror baby, but even I could get used to it. The game has also gotten a free content update recently called Aftershocks, so there's now even more to play even after you reach the credits. Now, I know, there are some games missing on this list. It was actually really hard to compile a top list this year as I adore so many VR games that came out, but if I named them all, the video would be too long and it would be really hard for you to pick one. So the goal is to make it easier for you, so I just named my personal favorites. The games that have made the most impact on me. So feel free to let me know if you disagree or you have other games that you think are Game of the Year. Let me know what your Game of the Year is down below in the comments so everyone can get more tips. Since it is Christmas, I'm also giving away an After the Fall Quest game key to one lucky commenter down below who answers that question. So good luck everyone, and again, happy holidays. I hope you have a great one, and I will see you back next week. Special thanks to all our champions, especially these shining armored ones, and as always, VR on!